This is Architect Mai, in today's story we are going to see another method we can use to model a house or houses. Last week we saw a video where we made a house or we created a house using the ArchMesh. This time we are going to see how we can use building tool, an add-on you can add into your software, which is Blender, and then it eases the work. Building tools is a free add-on which you can get from GitHub. So let's see how we can use it to model a house or a home. So to get started, let's delete this cube. Then I'm going to press N on my keyboard. Then go to building tools. So the first step we are going to do is to click on create floor plan. So you come here in its settings. We've got different floor plans. We have the rectangular floor plan, we have circular, we have composite, we have edge shaped, and we have random. So for this story, I'm going to use random. So let me click on random, and this is it. So we are going to start our modeling from this. So this add-on works when we are in the editing mode. So what we are going to do, we are going to switch to the editing mode by pressing the tab button. Then we are going to go to the face selection mode and we select everything. So let's start adding other features. Let's start with the floors. I'm going to click on add floors. So you can add lots of floors as you want. So under the settings, floor count. So far we have one floor. We have the floor height. You can increase it. We have the slab thickness, slab outset. So you have to just play with this. So let me add a second floor. So for the case of the height, you can also choose to increase it, but for this case I'm leaving it at 2 meters. So let's add a door. Remember, I said we make changes while we are in the editing mode under the face selection mode. So I'm going to click on this and click on add door. So we've also got different kinds of doors under the fill type. So we have the panels, glass panels, we have rovers. So I'm going with this rover. And you can choose to add its the width, the height, and everything. So let me increase the width to 3. So that's the door. So maybe you can add about the stairs. So I'm going to click on this, then go to add stairs. This is what we've got. So let's make it proportional to the size of the door. Let's go under the settings. We increase the width to 3. The door size is 3. So let's increase it to 3. Yeah, I guess you can see the changes we are getting. So we can choose to add windows. Maybe the first window here. Go to add window. So since we have used roofers under the field tape, I'm going to select the same tape, increase its width to 2. Like that. Can decide like we add maybe a door and a window at the same time. So I'm going to add them here and click on multiple group. So when I click on this, it gives us the option of a window and a door. Maybe we add a balcony somewhere here. So I'm clicking here and add balcony. Add balcony. So we have our balcony. Let's increase the width to 2. So these are very, very essential tools or add-ons which can simplify the work. You just have to make adjustments or changes with the building you've decided to use. Maybe let's add a window somewhere here. Like 2. Count, we go to count 2. Maybe we add others here. More 2 windows. Yeah, I think we are good to go. You can also choose to add here. Depends on what you want. So the house is now more realistic. We have the doors, we have the windows, we have the floor, we have the stairs, we have the balcony. So let's now work on the roofing. So I'm selecting the top part, then go to add roof. So there are different kinds. We have the hip, which is this. We have flat, this one. We have the gable, the less steep to hip. So that's the simplest way of how we can create a home using building tools.